We're live.
You're live.
We are live. MJ Rodriguez.
Hello.
I'm Paul Wontorek. Thank you so much for being here. Look, MJ Rodriguez just stopped by.
Just stopped by
the bro, and I'll come offices, and I said, well, we need to go to everybody.
But I love this man, y'all. Yeah, I don't know, this man is an amazing person.
Oh, thank you. It's going to be about me? No, it's going to be about you.
Okay.
Because let's talk about this. You are my summer obsession. I am so obsessed with Pose, the Ryan Murphy show. You are the star. You are Blanca.
Blanca.
Oh my God. Last night, there was a new episode last night. There's only one more of the season.
One more, so make sure you tune in for the 8th episode finale.
I hope you guys are watching this fantastic show. And even if you aren't, you still can. And actually, it's great binge, like, if you watch a bunch of episodes in a row.
It's true, yeah, because I've done the same thing. I've watched 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, at least about 3 or 4 times.
Are you just watching yourself over and over?
Well, I don't see myself up there. It's kind of crazy. Really, believe it or not, I don't see myself. I was just talking to my mom yesterday about this. I watch with her sometimes. I watch with some of the cast, or I watch by myself. And I'll talk to the TV screen.
And say what?
And I'll be like, girl, Blanca, why'd you do that, girl? Or like yesterday, when me and my mom were downstairs watching it, my mom was like talking about Lil Poppy, and she was like, I don't know why he would do that. And I was like, I don't know why he would do that either. Blanca told him not to do it. And he comes in the house and does it anyway.
So it's weird.
I see MJ.
You're involved as a viewer. Yeah. You're removed from it.
Yeah.
So you filmed it, and you know what's actually happening. And then you're actually watching it as a viewer and experiencing it the way we are.
Exactly.
That's
and I
crazy.
Love that. I do that purposely because I did. Child, these nails will pop off. I do that purposely because I want to experience it just like any other audience member would experience it. I don't know if that sounds weird, but
I love that. Mm-hmm. I think that's amazing. I am so up in it.
I'm up in it too.
Now, I have been on pins and needles for weeks because I was terrified that there would not be a season 2 for Pose, but we just found out last week you got renewed. It is coming back for more.
Yes.
The category is second season romance.
Season.
Oh my God.
Second season romance.
I
CT. Okay.
Okay. Did you ever see like Paris is Burning?
Did you see it before? It's
a documentary about the ball scene.
About the ball scene. Yeah. It's like a glimpse into the ballroom scene, and like it shows it's a documentary about these lives of people who are of the LGBT community of color and how they move through the world.
And the houses. It really sort of gives you the backstory.
Mm-hmm.
I actually went to one of those balls back then. In that time. Yeah, I did. And I love how Ryan Murphy is a genius, mm-hmm. first of all, mm-hmm. for even thinking of this idea.
Mm-hmm.
And exploring this world, I think, because it's just so ripe with so much to talk about.
Mm-hmm.
But he's so good at like showing, making it feel authentic to the period, but also making it feel really fresh and hot. And like those scenes in the ball, ball scenes.
Is
it fun to film?
It was fun to film. I loved every single aspect of it. And there's always a topic, or there's always like a subtitle, or there's always a title or theme to the ball. So like every single episode, you're going to see a different ball.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
You're going to see
some different type of aspect to the ballroom culture. So
and you're
going to
see Billy Porter as Pray Tell.
Yes. For commentary.
Work.
The chance
live.
Who makes it all come alive.
Pose.
Pose. Work. Live.
Aside from it being just a fantastic television show with great drama and great characters and me crying and cheering and everything, it's not all sad, but there's a lot of really, really good drama to latch on to. It's also an amazing milestone for visibility, for trans actors, for gay actors.
It's all inclusive. I mean, obviously, it's specifically, you know, there's stories on there that are very tied into the trans movement and especially trans women of color. But it's also inclusive to everyone. Obviously, you see Evan Peters on the show, and you see like Kate Mara, and the list goes on. It's inclusive to everyone. I mean, but it's telling a different story from different aspects. But we want the world. I'm going to speak for myself. I think we want the world to see how we move through life as just human beings, and how we found comfort in the ballroom scene, and how we found that place. That place was a place of refuge.
Mm-hmm.
And outside, we had to fend for ourselves most of the time.
Yep.
Whereas if we were in the ballroom scene, we had a group of family members that were part of the LGBTQ community.
Yeah. It's all about building a family, which,
yeah.
you know, so many things are about that.
Yeah.
It's all about finding your own family
exactly.
and the houses, and you're a mother. You're a mother in the house.
Mm-hmm.
I love it.
I and I love it. I can't complain. It's funny. So a little personal, a little background check about me. I've always wanted to be a mom. I've always wanted to have a husband and kids and everything. And I mean, I'm still young, but also I'm getting older. And I was like, okay, well, when is it gonna happen? And then out of nowhere, this show came, and I gained so many children outside of just like speaking biologically, but like outside, just like kids who come to me and they're like, "Hey, mother," and I'm like,
"Wow."
And they're young. They're
fans of the show.
Fans of the show.
Wow.
14, 15, 16. You know, some I got some people a little older, but it's good to know that now I'm a mother to all people versus just,
yeah, you got some older people too.
Oh, stop it.
So what's it been? You came out as trans a few years ago.
Yes.
And you've been sort of on the scene, and you've been very, you know, I follow you on social media, mm-hmm. and even before Pose came out, I feel like you're very out there.
Yeah.
You're very, like, out there with people sort of talking about your journey
yeah.
as an actress, and, like, what kind of roles you're going in for, mm-hmm. and I like when you sing live sometimes on Facebook. I used to like that. I'd be like, oh, MJ's singing.
I still do
it
sometimes. I mean, I'm a little busy now, but, like, you know.
And you sang on Pose, too. Yeah, that episode 7, I believe.
6.
Okay, sorry. 6. I love that you know them all by heart.
Because I'll be watching that. Kind of crazy.
So what has it been like being out there, on the scene, looking for work, and then what was it like finding out the show was happening, and when you found out the show was happening, you were like, hello, I need to, Mr. Murphy, MJ, hi. Like, what was it like going in for this? And I don't know, it just must have been like it must have felt like such a dream opportunity.
Yeah, it was. I mean, it was, in the beginning, it was a blessing for everything because, like you said, I had come out as, like, medically transitioning. I mean, we talked about this in interviews before, that I've always known I was a girl. I've always known that. But as far as protection goes and as far as all these other things, as far as what I thought the world would do to me if I would live authentically, I thought that I wasn't going to be able to live. I thought I was going to be gone before I even got this chance. Mm. But as we all know, time is a place for everything. And I planned out my timing on how I wanted people to know how I was medically transitioning, and that was happening in Brent. Mm-hmm. That was like the precipice of everything when I wanted people to know. And then
she played Angel.
Yeah,
fantastic.
Mm-hmm. And then down the line, I just started living unapologetically. I moved out of my way, and I just was patient, and I waited and waited and prayed and waited on everything, and spoke a lot of things into the universe. Mm-hmm. And so when this opportunity came, you're right, it was like a dream. It was like everything had fallen into place, like how it needed to fall into place. I got out of my way, I started living for me, and I also started doing what I love and doing it as the person I am. And it was the most beautiful way of just like receiving. This is a gift that I've always asked for, and I'm glad that I have it in my hands. And it's a responsibility too,
mm-hmm.
you know, just to be a part of something like this. So it was a dream, it was a wild dream. And I'm riding on that thing like a stallion, baby. Just like, sorry.
Okay. You're a good person. You deserve it. You deserve it. And honestly, it shows when people who watch the show, mm-hmm. people who don't know you, who I'm friends with, have fallen in love with you and your character because that warmth, it just comes out of Blanca. I mean, you need that in that role. And,
yeah, you have to have, I
mean,
they have
she's
to
She's kind of an innocent in the
kind of,
world.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? There's something about, like, I was even thinking about the ball scenes.
Mm-hmm.
She's not always the most fabulous one in the room.
No,
you know what
no,
I mean?
No.
There's a lot going on with her. So there's a lot of things to play there.
And I think that's the best part. I think, and I love how Ryan would give inputs when he was directing, and he would say things like, you know, you guys are playing the underdogs and the people who have to come up and, you know, have to rise up. And I love that because in my life, I was an underdog. I was bullied and I got beat up, you know, from time to time. So being able to tap into that, it felt good to be able to be in that space and like tap in and pull from your personal life, and also as an actor, you pull from other experiences as well. It was great.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Do you want to do more stage work?
Do you want to do more stage work?
Can we talk about how many trans performers are on Broadway or coming to Broadway?
That's
I mean,
everything. Peppermint, that's my sister. I love her.
Yes, Peppermint is in Head Over Heels.
She's in Head Over Heels.
Yeah.
And there are many others. Oh, Anish. I don't know if you've heard of her, but but she's an amazing actress. I've worked with her before. She's in White Men, Straight White Men.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. And Kate Bornstein. Yeah, yeah. Anyway, it's amazing how the theater industry has really sort of. I feel like they're like kind of like, well, we're gonna step up and, you know, we're gonna. So we need you back on the stage.
I hope so. That would be nice.
I'd be into that.
That'd be nice. I would love to send my face down just one more time on the chain. You know, so.
But you got a lot of posing to do, because I don't know when season 2 is going to film, but that's going to be, you're busy.
Yeah, I got a lot of things that I haven't, I just did something, hush, that's going to be coming out.
Okay.
I'm just going to say lookbook, and that's it.
Yeah, okay, look for it.
So be on the lookout, y'all.
Yeah, totally. Is there
questions?
Yeah.
We have so many questions.
Yes.
Can I see
your notes?
Oh my gosh,
yes, if you can read my handwriting.
Okay, I can read your notes.
All right.
It's getting ready.
I can't read your notes.
Okay. All right, Caroline wants to know, do you have any advice for people that want to be performing?
Okay, so this is what I would say as far as like the technical aspect of it, and when you first get into it, the first thing first is get some headshots, start running up that resume, and then just going out and auditioning as much as possible. And then when you start going into, you go into the audition process, make sure you are yourself. Don't try to be anyone else. Be yourself within the character, if that makes sense. Because people want to see you. They want you to bring you to the table. And most of the time, they already want you.
All right, another great question is, how did you start singing on stage?
Oh, my God. Okay, so can I just tell you? My mom was getting me into programs. This is when I was living in Jackson, New Jersey at the time. And she put me in this program at the age of 7. I can't remember because, memories of... a little bit.
First
again. But it was The Greatest Love of All, and that was the first time. I didn't sing solo, but it was a group of kids, and I was nervous as all hell. But as soon as the music hit me and it flowed through me, I was like, oh my God, this is the moment what I've always wanted to do, and it feels great. So that was the first time I was going to sing when I was 7 years old in a program, a young youth program.
I love that. Joanna says that she hasn't started watching Pose yet, but who do you suggest she watch it with?
Okay, I like that question. Joanna has a question. Okay, so I would suggest, we have a lot of our LGBT community members watching it already. That's something that just like is a given for them. They're like, we want more of our stories being told. What I would suggest, and whoever you would like to tag along, is possibly if you have people who don't understand the community that well, and even if they're not willing, try to influence them to see if they want to learn about it. And the people that do want to learn about it, tag them along. I'm sure they'll enjoy it. So people who don't understand technology.
It really does. It really explores a lot of things about trans lives, especially at that time,
right.
in the late 80s.
Right.
And it really explores, what they were going through in such a real way, in such a relatable way.
Yeah.
And
well, it's funny because to tie in Paris is Burning. Paris is Burning is obviously very, very different from Pose, but it was a lens, it was a glimpse into our lives in 1988. It was a glimpse into our lives and what we went through, but there wasn't any aspect of it afterwards because whatever reasons, we don't know. But now that Pose is here, it's shedding light on the lives outside the ballroom scene and the real, the realness of how anyone would live, living in a house, getting an apartment, having kids. It's opening that door to showing how normal we live as well.
Yep. A bunch of people asked, do you have any tips for remembering lines?
Y'all, okay, so what you have got to go over your, once you get your lines, you have got to go over them for at least about a week before you.
How far in advance did you get your scripts proposed before you
got
the film?
We got our scripts usually about a month in advance.
Okay.
Sometimes we get them a month in advance, maybe even 3 weeks in advance.
Okay.
I read through my script about 2 times. And then afterwards, that's when I did the work. I was just hammering it so that I can get, especially with all the lines, up in the air, but I live for it. But you have to. You have to make sure you go over them. You know you have a due date to study.
Yeah.
to film. Make sure you study all the way up until that day so you can just let it happen. And there won't be any inhibitions about what you have to do. You have everything planned out.
Did you have any favorite Blanca looks or outfits?
I sure did.
Episode number?
I have a lot of looks that I was for. I have a lot of looks that other characters had too. For me, I love that blue, the blue Black Elsa outfit, giving you very Frozen. And it was the fifth episode.
Okay.
Mother's Day or fourth episode? Mother's Day, fifth episode.
Mother's Day. Oh my God, that episode killed me.
Yeah, it was the blue dress. And then, I want to tell you another one of my favorite ones, but I can't tell you yet.
Oh, next week? It's next week.
Next week
was a good one. The final episode of the season is next Sunday night.
Yes.
What are you going to be doing?
I'm going to be watching the show.
Again? And then all summer you're going to watch the show.
I'm going to watch the show. Listen, y'all, I really like it. And it's not because I'm in the show. It's like, I'm not a cocky person at all. But like, I've watched Ryan Murphy's shows throughout my life. I've watched Glee. I've watched Nip Tuck. I've watched American Horror Story.
Yeah.
I love his work.
Yeah.
And I've always wanted to work with him. When Glee came out, that was like, I was in high school at the time. I'm talking a lot right now. It's
okay. No.
When I was in high school, Glee had come out. I was about 14 or 15. And I was I was in art school, went for vocal, and I was trained in classical music for 4 years at that school. And I said, oh God, I mean, I love classical music, but can we have some, like, you know, some show choir up in this piece? And I went to my teacher, Dr. Borges, I love him. I was like, Doc, can we do this? And at that time, you're a kid, you don't know how to organize nothing. He was like, no, MJ, I don't think you can do it. And I was like, dog it. And I was so upset and, you know, sad. But the reason why I wanted to do it, because I lived for the work of Ryan Murphy. Mm-hmm. So, like, I love watching this show because it's him. There are other beautiful people that attend to it.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I love it too.
But I'll be watching it on Sunday, y'all, so I'm going to give y'all a hint. Canary Bird. That's all I'm going to say.
Big Bird? Tweety Bird? Big Bird?
Oh, no, not Big Bird. No, Tweety Bird. Maybe like Phoenix Bird, but like Canary. Sorry, y'all.
Thank you so much. We have other things to do with this one, so we're going to wrap this up. Thank you guys for watching, and check out Pose. If you haven't seen it yet, it's okay. We're not judging, but get into it now.
Yeah.
Because now season 2 is coming. So
right,
by the time season 2 comes out next year, you're going to be really wrapped up in it, trust me. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much, MJ.
Thank you.
Bye, guys.
Bye, y'all.